He's a person of the past century. Well, yeah, so what can I say? I like the old time control. When it was 5 hours to for 40 bulls. And nowadays I believe, well, the more time the better. And of course it is a progressive feature that they give additionally a bonus. 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 30 seconds. This is of course, this is good, yeah.
Mr. Kotschner.
Yeah, well.
Can you tell us a short story about Bobby Fischer, perhaps?
About Bobby Fischer, also I'm telling a lot.
About Bobby Fischer, I'm telling a lot in
my book. And interesting that Bobby Fischer liked it. That is, he's now in Reykjavik, and I met some person from Reykjavik, and one Grant Martin, he said to me that Bobby Fischer has a very good opinion about me. Presumably, that I was telling, I was writing very good about you. You know that in the year 2001, one German journalist asked more than 30 grandmasters to answer the question, who was the best player of the 20th century? I was voting for Kasparov, but Fischer won that, won this competition with great margin. So, well, people believe that the best player of the 20th century means that the best player in the history of chess. And of course, well, the way he played, the way he beat, well, one, well, he destroyed the whole Soviet school of chess alone, absolutely alone. Well, let's say during the match with Spassky, 1972, he had, well, I don't know, a trainer, a coach. Well, it was William Lombardi, but Fischer didn't allow Lombardi to come to the chessboard. The task of Lombardi was to answer to the filthy letters from the Soviet side, just to answer to them. And not about chess. That's what happened. It's fantastic. Well, to do such a performance, one should be crazy. Presumably he is.
Another question. I mean, you play a lot of strong players, and even then you win.
Huh?
So you have played a lot of very strong players, and even then you win more than you lose. So what do you consider your greatest talent, that you can even beat those people?
My greatest talent?
Mm-hmm.
Well, why should I? Well, let other people ask, or tell about my greatest talent. I will leave. Well, I say for the book 100 Games, I've chosen, well, the more partners the better. So I had 100 games, 94 partners. Two games with Karpov, two games with Tal, two games with Hubner, and actually, one game against everybody, and there was a game against Fischer. With Fischer, I was equal. I won two games, I lost two games, and four draws, and also in the Blitz tournament, which he won in the year 1970, easily, I was the only one who beat Fischer. I won one, lost one. About Fischer, and I have games with Botvinnik, Tal, Petrosyan, who else? Geller, and so on. I did not try to to put the game with Kasparov. Kasparov, when he writes a chapter about me in his volumes on the world history of chess, he gives the game. I won against him, but it's a single game, and I didn't want to even to mention it. No, it was Kasparov's idea just to put this game.
Yeah,
I have a bad score with Kasparov, but nowadays when he quit chess, and he doesn't play chess any longer. Yet he, for him, for his ambition, it is poor, you know. To be a world champion, 1 million people admire him. When he would become, say, president of Russia, well, 150 million people would admire him, okay? That is something else, yeah. So he doesn't play chess anymore, and all of a sudden he has become my greatest fan. I was astonished that. Well, time ago, somehow we were competing, but now not anymore.
It's a question. How do you want the world, or maybe smaller roles now, how do you want the world to remember you?
How the world remembers me?
Yeah. How do you want
the world to remember me?
Yeah.
Well, again, I wrote very well. I think I wrote very good books of these selected games, and at least the people would enjoy my books. And that is okay. That's okay. So if you don't have any questions. So, let us start drink again, yeah? What can I say? But yeah. Well, you like to listen, but well, I don't know what to talk, what to tell you about.
Tal was drinking in this hotel in the 70s.
Huh?
Tal was drinking in this hotel in the 70s.
Tal was drinking
Here, also here.
Yeah. Well, so you know it better.
Coffee.
Yeah. I think.
Yes,
yes. Yeah.
Of course, now one thing, and a lot of younger grandmasters stop playing the game. How do you still keep
up? A lot of younger grandmasters stop playing. Yeah?
Stop playing. Yes. And What do they miss? What do you use them?
Well, but this is a problem. Well, how it happens that they start playing and they go for studies somewhere. They become students, and finally they are to be graduated from the high school, and now they have to choose between chess and a normal profession.
Mm-hmm.
And to earn money with chess, well, it is you have to prove every day that you are strong,
mm-hmm.
or the strongest. And when you say you have a degree, well, you are an academician or whatever, then it is once and forever for the rest of your life. But here, I am grandmaster, but well, there are more than 200 grandmasters. I have to show that I am not among 200, but among 10. Yeah, the best. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.